Parkinson. So I was a worker who experienced wage theft, and it was the Chinese Progressive Association that helped me win back my wages. So as workers, it's really hard for us to survive in the city with the current minimum wage. So with the current minimum wage, we're fighting for survival and we're not thriving. So today we're here to fight for an increase in the minimum wage all the way to $15.
So that was it for our speakers here. Are you guys ready for original March in Oakland?
Yeah!
I didn't hear you. I said, are you ready for the original March in Oakland?
Yeah!
All right,
yeah.
We're going to start congregating and heading down to the bar station so we can go to Oakland. So the bar station, vamos a empezar a congregarnos para viajar a Oakland. All right, a big thank you to CNA. Where are you guys at? Where you are? Hey, groups that are part of PWA.
All right,
on YouTube.
Yeah.
It's called Mayday, San Francisco.
Okay.
This man has never been arrested in his life. He was a law-abiding person. He had actually volunteered as an intern over at the Youth Guidance Center. That's the juvenile detention where I used to be, right? This man right here, so beautiful, scholarship student. And how is it possible that he could have pulled out a taser and pointed it at officers? That's impossible to believe. And then the audio recording signifies this. There's two shots and then a pause of 7 seconds. At the town hall meeting, the police chief claims that he's still threatening when he's been shot two times, and they admit he's on the floor. And so the 7 second space, there is no rationale why he's a threat, or else they would have kept blasting in him. Yep. 7 second pause, and then they unload 10 to 16 shots. And they still haven't admitted how many bullets there were. All right. That is only the beginning. Since then, the day after the murder of Alex Nieto by the San Francisco Police Department, you know what happened? They went over to the beautiful parents' home. The parents have never been involved with the police. Son inmigrantes, los parientes de Alex. Y comenzaron a interrogate him. They started interrogating them, and they started, touching things around their house. And they asked to search his house. After 45 minutes, when the father said, you know what, you're making me sick. I don't understand why this is happening. Then they tell him, your son's dead. Your son's dead. How can you explain this, huh? This is a total travesty. We gotta do something about it. Right now, por favor, let's repeat this chat. Amor for Alex. Amor for Alex. Amor for Alex. Gente, you could get involved. Find out more about this. Go on our website, justiceforalexnieto.org. Also, if you're on Facebook, join the Justice for Alex Nieto Facebook page, all right? Sign the petition, all right? Get involved. We cannot allow these lies to continue, all right? This is a direct result. His death is a direct result of gentrification, all right? And he was an honest worker, like all of you. We cannot allow another worker to be killed on the street for no reason, all right? God bless you all.
Thank you. That's what Let them go! nothing.
Get him! Fire! Oh!